The chief medical officer of the fire department of New York invited us to bring the solution to two of their simulations. You know, these big medical tents being set up, all these firefighters everywhere in their suits. And when it came time to do the disinfection, like, you could hear this like gasp among the crowd. They're like, whoa, it's so blue. And chief medical officer turns to me and says, how do I buy this stuff? And so literally that night, the three of us decide, hey, let's start a company.
That's a great demo. Your first demo, and you get your first customer.
At that time, we were still balancing school and this project. This project wasn't clear where it was going to go. Is this just a hackathon that I'm going to put on my resume? Is it just a cool side project, but I really should be focusing on my classes? And I was just so excited at the time about the idea of having a first customer that it seemed like the very obvious next step.
It all started here, right, with the challenge from Columbia Engineering.
Yeah, so back in 2014, when I was in my junior year studying biomedical engineering here in this lab, Columbia had this Ebola design challenge to help the frontline workers battle the Ebola outbreak in West Africa. And one of the things they mentioned over and over again is, man, I really wish I could see what I was doing. And that's what really sparked the idea behind colorized disinfection and highlight at Kinnos. When we went there and we deployed Highlight, they told us, like, this is the first time the entire outbreak that I've actually felt safe. You know, that's what really solidified the mission for us and made us realize we're actually working on something important here.
This is a great example of lead user innovation, where you're starting off with the extreme need and applying it more broadly to the healthcare industry, to hospitals. A lot of people become infected in a hospital.
Some of the nastiest pathogens are actually from the environment of care. You know, there's a good chunk that are transmitted through surfaces. And one of the reasons why surface disinfection is so important is because you have to use friction and elbow grease to remove whatever's physically there on the surface. So we had to develop a different delivery mechanism.
Show me how it works.
You can sort of think of it like a printer and ink cartridge system. You have a reusable lid device that prints the color on top of the ready-to-use wipes, and then you have this cartridge that contains the highlight chemistry. So this is the secret sauce. So that's the entire setup. And then you basically just press a button, and as you press it, you get these colorized wipes.
Can I do it? This appeals to the compulsive in me. It's fading.
Yeah, so the technology actually helps train on technique, because if it's darker, it's actually telling you need to apply a little bit more pressure there. So it's actually giving the end user real-time feedback.
I understand the basic idea behind Kinnos, right? There's a blue dye, and that dye fades over time. Why had nobody done that before?
Colorized disinfection has been something that people have wanted to do for over 25 years. But the challenge is, how do you get a color to last in a disinfectant and only have it disappear when you use it on the surface?
This is all Kinnos?
Yeah, this entire row right here is where we do our synthetic chemistry.
So you're making new molecules here?
Yes.
Molecules that have never been made before?
Yes. It turns out most people aren't trying to make dyes that go away. They're trying to make dyes that stay. So how do we look for dyes that are unstable enough that they will fade quickly?
So this is the secret sauce of Kinnos. And you got the secret sauce dispenser
exactly.
That we looked at earlier.
Yes.
Put the two together, and you got
Highlight.
The core of the business, so you got Highlight. What about the business story? What's your pitch to your investors?
We're starting with healthcare. That's the gold standard, right? If it's good enough for a hospital, it's good enough for a cruise ship, or it's good enough for a laboratory. Every single time we've brought this to hospitals, we get so much feedback like, I really want this for my own household. You know, taking a step back, it's about a global standard that democratizes safe environments of care for everyone.
It's human-centered because it was driven initially by, you know, a real human need. So you're addressing a very important human problem with a very simple but elegant solution.